Welcome friends, welcome to Book Talk Tips. Our today's book is Return of the Gods by Jonathan Cahn. It's a New York Times bestseller. A quick summary about the book is, we have come across, if you are part of any Abrahamic religion or something, you would have already come across a lot of satanic forces and all these pagan gods, all these things. Idol worship and all these things. So, but in the recent generation or on the last one century or something, you don't feel that presence of those gods. Unlike in our myths or mysteries or all these things, what is being told on the holy scriptures and all. So this book is revealing that part of the gods, like a pagan gods, not the actual gods, those gods who was there before in Mesopotamia and Babylonia, and then they are back here, the return of those gods. So that's our books today. Welcome to Book Dot Tips again. So let's get started. Part 1, mystery. As we mentioned, the pandemic of now and the Supreme Court ruling of abortion and all these things, we would have not think it in a way that this is all related to any pagan god or any other forces like that. But the book is trying to put that on a perspective, and not only that, it is trying to prove it also. So these incidents, what's happening now, like homosexuality and drag queens and pride parades, abortion cancellations and all those, even the symbols of Wall Street and all these things have some impact or having an influence of these gods. We'll explain more. A short warning is that the mystery revealed in this book will be touching the sacred cows of the culture and age. So book is trying to explain the topic in terms of Judaism and Christianity and based on Bible and all these things. So if it anyway, by through the book or through by our interpretation, is it's hurting any particular religion, please consider it is purely coincidental and we have no particular purpose to harm any other religion or anything. Just for educational purposes only. So the return of the gods. God as old as religions and prophets. If you remember the very earliest religion, you will still see that there is an anti-god there. There is a good god and there is a negative forces there in the beginning. That's why even in the Babylonian Mesopotamia, which is known to be the first civilization available for us, these have that impact of those gods. Mainly we are talking about three gods. We'll go into that. Thrive of the religion and disappearance of gods. So on the past era, or even now also, the majority currently, there is, we are part of a one god, or even the majority of the worship may be either in Christianity or Judaism or Islam, and there is still some other religions as well. But idol worship is still there. So in the modern time or in the prehistoric time, there was a time where spirituality was more influenced. But then later on, nowadays, it's more than spirituality. We have some other influences. So that's the main core of this book. Modern time, we don't think or notice them. Because we see things as 9-to-5 works and all these things, salaries and promotions, making all these materialist things. We don't find a way to just find it that way. Spirits of enlightenment, freedom and liberation. So that's all these forces are. But nowadays, if you look at those things, those are not really such a thing. So these are the like liberation forces, freedom and all these things. But we see it as not such a point. So part two is spirits. So spirits, these are the gods, because in Old Testament and in the New Testament also, it's mentioned Shadim. Shadim is mentioned as spirits. And in the New Testament, that is come to known as daimonia, which is from where the word devil come to the point. So sacrifices to Shadim. It is mentioned in the that in one of the holy scripture, they serve their idols, which became a trap for them. They even sacrificed their sons and daughters to daimonias. So this was on the prehistoric Babylonian age, where they served as a, they were worshipping those gods, and they were in almost all civilization, they have some prophetic influence. But still, they were worshipping these anti-gods and all. So there are many names you see around them, like in almost all culture, if you're in any part of the world, you will still see some part of the gods which we are explaining here. There are many names, but I'm just telling, mainly there are three gods on this. So civilization is possessed. Mesopotamians to Greeks, to Romans, to Zambians, to Taiwanese, to Eskimos, to the people of Africa, Asia, South Africa, and North America, and Europe. I'm sure you will be any of these countries, so, or any of these continents, you will still see this influence of this one in the history known to you, but currently you will not notice it. But this book is going to reveal and connecting the dots, so you'll understand that it's a mass phenomenon, not only in temples, they were everywhere. To light of the gods, Bible accounts for Jesus and spirits. 4th century Roman Emperor Diocletian, he was having a great persecution for the Apollo god, temple of Apollo, which is known as oracle god. Even in the Julian of Apostate, year 362, the emperor went to the Apollo god and she tell that I can recreate for you. So emperors was worshipping those gods. So the Apollo god tell that, this is after the Christianity's effect on the civilization, tell the emperor that my hall has all fallen to the ground, Phoebus. No longer has his house, Apollo god, not have his, nor his mantic bay, nor his prophetic spring. The water is dried up. So I have less hope on this civilization, which is now getting inspired by the actual religion. Whatever is that religion, which is believing on that one God, which is that omnipotent God, instead of believing on some spirits or some idol worship. This is what that era, when the Roman era, this was the reply to that. So that was the situation of that. House of spirits. When an unclean spirits, this is from the Bible again, when an unclean spirit goes out of the man, he goes through the dry places, seek rest and find none, then he says it will return to my house which I came. What it necessary telling is that suppose a man doesn't have any faith, so that is an unclean spirit that goes out of a man, then it will either find an evil spirit, and when it return back to that same person, because it will not find any other place to go, it will find either it will come alone, it will come with seven more. So that's about the individual possession, because we feel like we all having this possessions of spirits and all these things. The parable is talking about individual possession, but it's mostly talking about a collective possession of the whole society. A society was possessed by these gods. So that's why even we think it why somehow foolish that why they are worshipping their own creatures or their own sculptures, what they built by their hand. This is the possession of that god and power of this god. They were repossessed, and far more prehistoric Nero was far better than the past Christianic Adolf Hitler. So Dark Trinity, these are the three gods which is explaining in this book, and it is going to explain in the modern context. So a word before revealing about the gods and the principalities. The book of Ephesians by Apostle Paul, he tells that we do not war against flesh and blood, but this is from the gods, Paul is telling, but the principalities against powers against the rulers of darkness of this age, against the spiritual host of wickedness in the heavenly places. Paul is telling this. We do not war against flesh and blood. Instead, we war against the principalities of these things. And we war against their powers, against the rulers of darkness of this age. Again, it's mentioning against spiritual hosts of wickedness in heavenly places. When you see the current era, you will see a lot of these principalities, a lot of these dark cults and all these things are more nowadays. But even though we will not notice it, we are living in a more logical world, which we think that way, then we ignore a lot of things around us. So Dark Trinity. Gods of apostasy, old Israel and new America. Just a word before we start explaining about it. The dark trinities have a greatest effect on Israel because Israel was the holy place where most of the great prophetic or religions was happened. It's most happened in the Middle East. So that was like that area or that region of Middle East, that was ancient Babylonian, Mesopotamian and all. So Babylon was one of the richest cities all. So right now, that counterpart or that example of old civilization Babylon, the current Babylon is America. Or to be more clear, the Babylonian city is the New York City. So just keep that in the context, because the whole explanation of this dark trinity's effect on Mesopotamia and Babylonia, that is explained now, because those dark trinities are returning back, and they're returning back to the new Babylon, which is New York City. So three of the gods, first one is Baal, second one is Ishtar, and third one is Moloch. So first one we will tell about, this is Possessor, the Possessor. This is the first god. You'll see in multiple names in multiple places, even if you're living in, but you'll see similarities there. So he is Baal god is the most powerful of these dark trinities. He is considered as anti-god, the most powerful anti-god. Mostly it looked like the face looked like a cow or something. And he is a god of fertility, prosperity and fulfillment. So he gave this to the people and they worship him back. Epitome of all that is what is not god, that is Baal. He's a supreme god. In Greek mythology, you call it Zeus. In another mythology, you have another names. I don't want to particularly hurt any of that particular region. That's why I'm not. But the book is telling about some names as well. So this is a short picture taken from a website just for a reference only. So the Possessor returns. Maybe we don't think that Possessor is returned, but we will tell you how. He's telling that Possessor returned to America. The new Israel is one nation, one God. Because George Washington or that America was founded by that one nation under one God. So American have an amnesia now. It's a God effect. Removing prayers from schools. Religion has limited freedom. Religion is not that. You shall have no other gods before me. This was the first of the Ten Commandments received in Mount Sinai to Moses. So that is no more now. So you have a lot of gods now. 1980 Supreme Court on tablet. Like a lot of things was mentioned there on this one. God is removed, void stays. So when the God in the recent era, like immediately, just example after 1960s and all, there came a way that people are getting away from God to a lot of materialist things. So if you look back to the old from Bible, what Jesus is telling, when God is gone, that void, it will not stay as void. Something will fill there. What it will fill, because when the good is gone, the bad will fill there. So that's why the Possessor, the anti-Baal, he's returning first. Because he's the most powerful of the anti-god. Exchange of gods. It's not a culture war. Perceptions are getting reversed. You will not see it as a war. the perceptions and principalities, which Paul was telling that we are going to fight against those principalities. That same principalities is possessing it back. So molten beast. So this is the first sign of Baal is back. Because the Almighty God, the bull god. So the point is that when Moses was getting revelation from God at Mount Sinai, there was, then they waited for Moses. They were worshipping a golden calf as per the testament. So that was they considered as a god, Baal god. This things, you will find it in many culture about this cow being sacred and all these things. But what it is trying to explain is that in 1960s, Wall Street got the bull. It's a bull market. It has a history which is not mentioned in this book. It has a history like one of the investors, he just funded himself and make a bull in Wall Street. And after some time, police was taken that away because it was just made by someone else. But later on, a group of people gathered and put it back there. So in the very arch or entrance of New York City, you see a bull there. So that is the first sign of Baal is back to the society. George Washington tell that ever turn from God, then we will not be protected like that. So if you see that a comparison, this is the Wall Street bull. And you see, this is a golden calf, just for a comparison, just for imagination. So this is a molten beast. It's a molten god. This is also based on metal. This is also based on metal. And it is a bull. This is also a bull calf. So you see a similarity. A sign is back now. Deep magic. Gods, isms and revolutions. If you see after 1960s, especially after World War II and all, you see a lot of isms and revolutions. And a lot of like communism and all those things, Soviet Union and all these things. So that's mainly anti-God and all these things. So many gods, many truths, somehow, because there can be many truths and many gods. If it is many truths, then there is no truths. So Baal, Israel, worship on nature. So they were worshipping on nature. Now also there is worshipping nature and merging creation, creator to creation, man-God. So whatever they are creating, they were worshipping it. So somehow they make that creation as God and the creator as God. Then they are God. That is God. Everything else is God. Then there are many truths, many gods, and there is no truths at all. So that's what this chapter. The masters, because the Baal, that word is known to as Lord and Master and all these things. Mainly he sacrificed life and health and family. Nowadays, if you look at the new culture, we sacrifice lot of things like life and all this sacred life and everything, health, our family, our things, just to get money and just to become masters of all these things. So Paul at Athens used to tell that techne is the things where they are influencing and all. This is based on the old. Currently, if you look at the technology, that word technology come from the word techne. So we are now worshipping the technology. We are now worshipping the Silicon Valley. We are now worshipping the Wall Street, the billionaires and all those monies around them. So worshipping what they have built. So that's what the reason Baal is coming back. Even the arch, we mentioned at the beginning that New York City is like an arch, like Babylon have an arch. So like similar to that, New York City, the arch we see is there. So when Babylon was excavating and all these things, they found in Temple of Palmyra in Syria, they had lot of remains of lot of symbols and all these things. So in the arch, the symbol, there was an eagle there. It's from the Temple of Palmyra. If you look at the two images, this one is from the Temple of Palmyra and this is a United States stamp. From the book itself, the author is telling, like, there is a great similarity of this one. So even in Wall Street, even in the stamp of United States, we are capturing Baal there. So that's an idea here. Golden calf civilization. So Moses with gods, Israel with calf, faces of Moses. So the point is that we previously explained that when Moses was getting the revelation, when he looked from the down, from the top to down, he see that they were worshipping this golden calf down. Now if you see the same thing, Capitol Hill have Moses in the center. If you see the picture, this is from there. Capitol Hill have Moses in the center and Confucius and Solomon and all these things. So now if you see, the Wall Street down, they were still worshipping, Wall Street is still worshipping that molten calf, molten bull, worshipping the money and worshipping, because money, now the almighty become the almighty dollar, and Wall Street is a temple of that. So sin was now holy and holiness was now sin. You see lot of perceptions, lot of versions now. You cannot define it as a sin. There is always a way to make a holiness to the sin. So somehow sin was made as holy and holiness was sin. Whatever you think about in as a sin is now the whole perception has changed. So that is about the first god, that is Baal. Now we are going to talk about the second god. It is a lady, same time a lady and a man, but she's mostly lady. It's an enchantress. We'll see how her effect is there later. So she is known to as Ishtar. And another name, Aphrodite, Venus, lot of words, but you'll see lot of her influence there. So she's a queen of heaven. She's the daughter of moon and her brother is sun. She's a Venus god. She's the goddess of prostitution. She is being worshipped in the beer parlors and the same places where she's a god of prostitution. She's lived in where there is her worshippers just transgender themselves and they become homosexual, like cross-dressed dracoons and all these things. So she is known as enchantress, sorceress and goddess of magic. So if you see this symbols here, like lion god, and she's sitting here and it's worshipping. This is from Mesopotamia. And the enchantress return. Let us see how. Israel first turned to Baal and then Baal to Ishtar. Same is happening here. When the God returned to Wall Street. God returned there as a dollar. And now then they started sexual revolution. We'll see how. So premarital and extramarital become a new normal now. Now there is living together, extramarital relationship. It's not that bad before 1960s. It's something, prostitution become legalized in the countries. First country to do that was Soviet Union. That was the first country who changed from Christianity to communism. She was promiscuous. At the same time, she was multiple loves. She was a god and goddess of instant gratification. We are all the dopamine like enlived people. So we are becoming a worshippers of instant gratification. Even the place where we just tap our credit card, we are having that instant gratification. Sexual immorality becomes sanctified and make it holy now. So there is no immorality now. Even homosexuality and all these things are become new normals now. Sacred prostitute. She's, as we mentioned, Ishtar is a goddess of prostitution as well. Sex sells now everywhere. Movies, magazine, even the Hollywood is taken that one. America or the New York or America become the capital of pornography. The word erotica come from the word Eros. Eros is the god and an incarnation of Aphrodite. Aphrodite is an incarnation of Ishtar. So you see connection here. Greek word for prostitution is porn. And from that word, it become now pornography. As we mentioned, it is everywhere now. From the ads to all these things, you see that effect of sexuality there. And the part 3 is the third of the Dark Trinity. He's a destroyer. He is the destroying all these things. So his name is Malak. And is intoxicated with alcohol, drug culture. So that's what, like, a generation first, it is intoxication with alcohol, drug, then music, sex and drugs. Sexual revolution with feminism. Feminism with intoxications. So you'll see all these things coming across there. You see now music, pop music and all these things. Sex was there. Now drugs. Even drugs is now, like, people think that, okay, psychedelics is new normal now. Performance enhancement, all these things. And drugs was being used by, like, normal now compared to any other ages before. People are addicted to drugs and all these things. Feminism is a new liberation or freedom thinking now. So that's all change in there. Alcohol is new normal, like people celebrate with alcohol. So the destroyer and the darkest of the sins, what destroyer or Malak is doing is that he was the person, or the worshippers of Malak was sacrificing human beings to worship him. But what is the new sign for that now? Like, in the old culture, we see that children's life, even in the Moses time or before and all, children's life were in threat. Even they were changing the kids from here, there and all. Even the prophetic histories, if you look at it, you see that. So currently, the same thing is happening on an abortion. Before, abortion has become a very new normal now. It's like a symbol of freedom and all these things. In Paradise Lost, John Milton write about ancient God. First, Malak, horrid king, besmear the blood of human sacrifice and parents' tears. And through the noise of the drums and tremble loud, their children cries unheard that pass through the fire to grand idol. So there itself, John Milton is explaining that. This is a picture of Malak, God. He is a destroyer and all these things. It's taken from a website for reference. Abominable sacrifice. Because first we come the God worshipping, then we are just worshipping our emotions and all through Ishtar. Now this third one is Hitler. Churchill one time just referred Hitler as an embodiment of Malak. Children's life in threat and sacrifice of children. So there is no value for children life now. Even though we celebrate it as a marital freedom or all these things, our life, like, we are trying to sacrifice these things by telling about career of a people, career of a family or family life and all these things. But this is an influence of Malak as per the author. The destroyer return, as we mentioned. So Soviet Union, communism was the first to legalize abortion. Third of the Dark Trinity, the principality of death. In January 22, 1973, Supreme Court legalized abortion and the Malak came back. Baal ushered Ishtar. This is what we explained before. Baal was the first god. He just give way to Ishtar to return. When Ishtar is returned now, Malak will come back. So money to gratification to sacrifice. This is what the current generation is that. They were trying to just sacrifice everything to get money. And that money is used to get gratification of their life. And they sacrifice their children and all. Children's of prostitution was given as a sacrifice in the old generations. Like whoever worshipping Ishtar and all, prostitute was part of that worship, and whatever is created from that prostitution, that is getting sacrificed to Malak. Children's of altars. The Phoenicians and especially Carthaginians, whenever they seek to obtain great favor, when they want to get great favor from the god, they wove one of their children, burning it as sacrifice to the deity. This was the old. So new era mother life, as we mentioned previously about life, career, future, earnings and all these things. This was the reason now considered to sacrifice. Previously, they want to get some favor. They were sacrificing the this kid. So now new era, this is the same thing is happening, but we don't see it as like that. So it's a new era, mother's life, career, future earnings, it's all getting sacrificed there. So the valley of Hinnon, the Baal inspiration, Ishtar seduction and Moloch sacrifice, as we mentioned, 60 million children was being abortions in the new generation. This was an unprecedented effect, or Moloch did not get that much sacrifice in any of the prehistoric age. This is one of the unprecedented success of Moloch sacrifice now. So part the transformer, that is the next thing. So transformer, as we know, so we'll talk about more detail about this effect on the religions or effect of the people. Ishtar, as we mentioned, at same time lady of jewel, and she's a warrior. If you look at the picture, she's having a beauty there, and she's having a ferocity by a lion and a sword on her, this one, and she's, you see a lot of flowers or whatever it is. So though I am a woman, I am a noble young man. That is what, when some scriptures talking about Ishtar, she's feminizing men and masculinizing women. That's what effect of Ishtar. You see nowadays also, like even from the way of dressing to all of the things, you see that feminization of the men and masculinization of the woman is a new normal now. Metamorphosis of woman, injection of masculinity, Ishtar militarized woman. Just think that liberation of woman and the power from the very beginning on the childhood, they were getting empowered. And Jonathan Cahn is telling that that is a, that effect, and the boys are being getting on in another way, getting more feminized. They were getting couch potatoes and they were feeding video games and all. This is all part of that militarization of woman and the defeminization of men or boys. Metamorphosis of woman, the same thing, removing masculinity. There is no difference in identities now. If you look at now, like boys and girls, even the children age, sometime the girls or the babies of girls, they were being wearing the men dress and the other way, like, so there is no clear identity revelation like that. You sometime you will not even cannot identify between it's a baby is really a boy or girl. So sword is struck, relations are broken. This is what relations or difference between a gender is broken now after the hit of the sword by Ishtar. Androgynous, Asinu, Kargaru, Gala. These were the cross dressers who were the priest of Ishtar temple. So they adores men as women and women as men. Dracunes into the marine state. If you look at now, you see the Dracunes are inspirations and all these things now. So they are part of the back new stage now. Priest, gods and shadows. Like Akkadian text, it's an old text, reveal that instructed men sex with Asinu, a gay. Her female priest have extramarital affairs, and all this homosexuality was a sign of return. So this was all being practiced in Ishtar's temple. You see now that is returning now. It is a new normal now. So this is the personal assistant Ninsubar, she changed genders. Like when she was with Ishtar, she was in a lady, and when it was not, it is. So the new culture, new cult is getting castrated. Like we are having even a lot of foods is having the castration effect on all these things, cereals and all. You can research it. To transformer as exuberant or noble young man. So this was Ishtar's gift. Gender transition, like now hysterectomy, like changing a gender from one to there, this is 4,500% growth only between the 9 years, 2009 to 2018. So you see the effect of Ishtar there. Gender is getting changed as a new sign of civilization or empowerment like that. So part 8, it's explosion. It's also effect of Ishtar. Because this main effect of this change or effect of Ishtar really happened in Stonewall. It says, maybe if you know about the history, it's 1960s Stonewall riots at New York. This was a riot exploded. We will go into detail of that. then that ripples of that Stonewall riot was being sent to all over the world. Ishtar come through a gate. That gatekeeper no longer opened the gate, she opened it. That was the previous one. Ishtar was opened through a gate. So Stonewall, Ishtar returned at 1969 at Stonewall. So previously, like this is from the Pergamon Museum in Germany, 1918. This book somehow tell about this jubilee, something will return. This particular part is not mentioned in the book, but I'm just giving you. 1918, this museum built that Ishtar Gate in Germany. Just 50 years after, 1969, Stonewall returned again. So this 50 years, I have another important revelation. We'll come to that later. So the Stonewall, this gate, old Mesopotamian gate of Ishtar, this was made of bricks. You see there, this is all the things. The new stone wall, this is also made of bricks. This is a picture you can see. We'll go in more detail. The Ishdam. This is a temple of Ishtar. It's called Ishdam. Ishtar house is Ishdam. What is Ishdam? Ishdam is a tavern. A tavern, or simply, that means a beverage house or an alcoholic house. And the most of the best of what is being fed there is beer. That is a favorite in Ishdam. And Stonewall, the Stonewall in the same parlor, which is a tavern, which is an Ishdam, beer was one of famous for Stonewall. And House of Harimtu. The Ishdam was the house of Harimtu. Harimtu means prostitute. And Ishtar is known for homosexual men's and all. One of the main people who just get this, or main of the leaders of the Stonewall riot, was Marsha Johnson. He's a male prostitute. This is his picture. It looked like how. So that was the thing. So this house of Ishdam, the Stonewall, the gate, it was same time a beer parlor and same time a place for male prostitute or gender transition prostitutes. So stone wall was a facade of bricks. That was the old clay tablets is telling. Stone wall were the words of the symbol speak to us of goddess destructive consequences on the world around her, especially on her own people, her lovers. Stone wall was used as a condemnation that caused her offense and ignite her fury. So stone wall was the place where she will ignite his fury. So this was part of the old facade. So lion's head. So another symbol of ferocity of Ishtar, it's lion's head. So just author is trying to look, okay, did the lion's head also shown in Stonewall area in 1916 as a return of Ishtar? And what author found is that yes, there was a restaurant or a beer parlor, same, called Lion's Head, in the same street of Stonewall. This is a picture of that, Lion's Head. And avatars. In the old scriptures and all, they were talking about the effect of these things. So most of the people in Stonewall, they were men only, homosexual, gay people. But avatar of Ishtar is mostly a lady. So she's telling that, or author is telling, is there any feminine avatar available on Stonewall Riot? And the answer is yes. There was a lady, stream is Storm, and this is the lady's picture. She's having a masculine figure. She's a lesbian woman. And she, when the Stonewall was being closed by police, was arresting these people. One of the ladies getting arrested, she told that, why don't you guys do something? That was just like a proclamation for revolution. So she's the author is telling, this is again a symbol of that. A lesbian woman, she initiated. And the Ishtar is known for a storm god. So again, a name Storm is back again. Her name is Storm. She's having masculine figure. She's lesbian. And she initiated this one. So dance of goddess. So the night, the signs of goddess converge upon each other. The gate, the Ishtam, which is Stonewall, the prostitutes, the cross dressers, the homeless, the revived Asinu, the lion's head, the raging avatar named Storm, the arresting, the call to help and its response, Kazirtu, the dance of goddess, dancing was there, the battle, the smashing of the door, the employing of fire, the fury and the storm. This is all getting connected to the ancient revelations of this one. So the moon, the sun and the smell, a spell. The Ishtar lover, shepherd Tammuz. So one time she get offended to Tammuz and she got killed like that. So there was a month of Tammuz. This is the month where Ishtar is most ferocious. What is that month? We will come across. Stonewall happened in the same month. As per lunar calendar, month began on the full moon. And in 1969, that full moon happened in June 27 and June 29. Stonewall got sealed on June 26th. And the riot started on June 27, 1969. Exactly the same month of Tammuz, the same date, just exactly the same date as per the lunar calendar. We'll see the dominion of this procession of God. So in Stonewall, there was a parade happening in 1970. You see dragons, which is embodiment of Baal. We see bull, again, lion in terms of Ishtar. You see all these things there. Spectacles was like men's were dressed as women and women's was dressed as men in Stonewall riots. Purple garland and double-edged axe. So there was again another symbol which is again shown there. Sappho's Greek poet. Sappho was a Greek poet and is from there his word the Lesbos. She was a lesbian. So the lesbian word got from there. And there is a new flag now, lesbian freedom flag. And it is having the same purple of Ishtar. And it is having the double-edged axe. Same axe is used in ancient Minoan regions in the Bronze Age. This is used by lady priest for bull sacrifices. You know the connection now. Ishtar connection and all. And you see the double-edged axe. And this is now a symbol of lesbian pride. Again a connection of Ishtar back here. Junium, a frustration, as we mentioned before, this is a month of Tammuz, frustration month for Ishtar. It's a pride month at Stonewall, same time. Month of Tammuz, month of June. Israel turn away from God on the month of Tammuz. It's also part of the ancient scriptures. So you see again another sign, the pride flag is not any other flag. Pride flag is rainbow. And there is a reason for that rainbow. We'll come across. But this, what is it? This, each color of the rainbow means pink is representing the sex. Red is representing life. Orange color representing healing. Yellow color light of the sun. Green nature. Turquoise magic. Indigo serenity. Violet spirits. We'll just read back from the some of the old scriptures. This is about Ishtar. When the goddess Ishtar is asleep, a gardener rapes her. And when she awakes, she realizes that what has been done to her. She flies into rage and begins sending down plagues on earth. She then goes to her father and seeks to help. He tells her that when the gardener is hiding, she sets out to find him. How he sets out her mission is a vengeance is striking. You see now the new pandemic as per the God in another book. The new pandemic is actually a plague of Ishtar. Exactly after 50 years, 1969 was Stonewall and 2019 is the 50th year and the plague back again to the world. So that is COVID-19. So it is mentioned here, she stretched herself like a rainbow across the sky, across the aeroplanes, across the airports. You can just take it in another any other interpretation and reach thereby as far as on earth. You see how fast pandemic spread the earth. So in the month of June, exactly, this is what exactly where it's happening. The book is telling. In the month of June, within the days of summer solstice, towards the end of June, The day is especially identified as a festival of Tammuz. It is handed down in the days of ancient month of Tammuz. This is some of the important things, important events happen on those days. This is exactly the month of day of Tammuz is June 26th is the day of Tammuz. So in Babylonian calendar, a man to love a man. In June 26, 2003, there is no effect, but Supreme Court ruling of United States, June 26, exactly same date, 2003, Supreme Court legalizes homosexuality. Month of Tammuz, a month for Ishtar. Again, another June 26th, 2013, Defense of Marriage Act, same-sex marriage was being lifted out like that. Again, another June 26, 2015, legalized the same-sex marriage across America. On that night, rainbow appeared everywhere as a sign of God wrath. It was appeared on White House. You see the picture here, rainbow. It was appear on Empire State Building. You see a rainbow here again. So you see the effect of Ishtar everywhere in the icons of New York City, the icons of New Babylonia, the New York City. The war of gods, the vengeance of God, the rainbow effect. Every knee shall bow. Altars of God, the other God, and the removal of actual God. So that's what happening in the current generation. So vengeance of God is everywhere, but we don't notice it. And we are every knee is bowing down to the almighty dollar, to the almighty instant gratifications and all. And we are sacrificing our fetus and all these things. It's a new normal. Abortion is a new normal now. Homosexuality is a liberation now. Feminism is a new way of liberation and all these things. So that's the end of the book. Return of the God. Please let us know your feedback, comments and all. Until we come by next book. Bye for now. Thank you.